for the doubt avoidance tendency. Now, this tendency actually helped us survive back in the day. Put yourself in the shoes, or shall I say the bare feet of a Neanderthal or some other primal man. Imagine walking through the wilderness, the savannah, having a good old jolly time, and then you see a saber-toothed tiger or a beast just as formidable and ravenous. Are you going to think about what to do next, weigh out your options, or are you going to fight it or leg it? Luckily for us, built into our hard drive, into our DNA, we have the tendency where we can make a quick decision and stick with it. So in a situation like that, it will be fight or flight. You will make the choice and you stick with it, and this would help the species survive. Now, fast forward a couple of notches to 2015 or whenever you're listening to this audio. The chances are you're never going to be in a situation where you're going to have to fight or flight a saber-toothed tiger or anything of that caliber. So what happens is we still have a tendency, and it now works to our detriment, as we can make impulsive decisions that do not always benefit us or assist us. Some of the things we might just impulsively decide to do might not be productive, might be counterproductive. So this is where we have to be more conscious in our daily choices. Now, this doubt avoidance tendency is the reason why a lot of people cling onto their faith, even though there's hundreds of other religions, each as viable as the next, each with their own God, own messiahs. Once someone's chosen a religion, they generally stick with it and don't look at any other alternatives. This is all part of the doubt avoidance tendency. It's you make a decision and you stick with it. Now, this tendency, Charlie says, is triggered by puzzlement or stress. So when we're confused or when we're under a lot of pressure, that's when we generally act more impulsively. I'm sure you are aware of this, but let me give you an example. Imagine you're in a club and you see a girl and you want to talk to this girl. You walk over, you've got your swagger going. You're 1 meter away from her now. You look at her, she looks at you, and you quickly turn left. Walk away. When someone comes and asks you, why did you not commit to it? You have an array of excuses. She was on the phone. She was with her boyfriend. Or something along those lines. Now, this is the doubt avoidance tendency. We make the impulsive decision at the last minute to get us out of trouble. You had no reason to actually not talk to the girl, but you could justify your reasons just to avoid doubt. Now, this is a very dangerous thing. Or another example that I'm sure we've all actually experienced. Have you ever been on a website and you were thinking about buying a new item? You go to the checkout, and right before you purchase the item, you pull out, close the browser, go on YouTube instead and watch this video. Now, the smallest things can pull us off and make us make a decision. As soon as we feel a little bit unsettled, we can hop into this tendency just to avoid doubt and make impulsive decisions. So in 2015, we have to be a bit more conscious of every choice we make if we wish to be successful in our personal development. We cannot impulsively get out of something as soon as we feel uncomfortable. We need to slow it down and go from there. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. Peace. Alright guys, if you haven't already, make sure you check out the new Personal Development Global group on Facebook. Link is in the description. Heaps of good shit for ya. This is pretty much the go-to place for all your personal development articles, free content for everybody, and just the whole community that we're building up. There's no spam here. Also, you could check out the link to my website, The Realized Man, right at this website, and you can suss that out. If you have something to post, make sure you check it out and come on. Anyway, have fun, guys. Peace.